Thanks for stopping on our channel, which is dedicated to central heating. And as you can see, I've been doing this a long time. Whether you install or you have heating, hopefully my videos will make a difference, but please leave me a comment in the section below. Lights, action, camera, let's begin. Let's talk about all the mistakes installers make and some of the rip-offs that keep going round and round we've seen for years and years. Let's start from the bottom, the automatic bypass. I've made the video, we get lots of lovely comments. Thank you, George, because people, as I said, they do it wrong. But we get a lot of installers that rip off customers because they refuse to fit it. And it's there for a very good reason. Nothing to do with the manufacturer. This is codes of practice, British standards. They have a requirement that the heat exchanger in this boiler and all the other ones, that the water flows through at a constant rate, irrespective of the thermostatic radiator valve's position, because the TRVs will obviously go up and down as we do. And we know that, and the pressure increases. But if that happens on a boiler that's working, it's going to start making air bubbles and it turns into sludge and it ruins itself and the boiler. And that's why that is necessary for a combi system, it's compulsory, but all other systems, whether it's a Y plan or an S plan, they all need an automatic bypass. Not only does that keep the flow at a constant rate, but it also provides heat to leave the boiler and warm up those big double Ks that I've made videos for. So have a look at them and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And if you've got any comments, please leave them down below and I'll get round to answering them and with a great deal of pressure. The other thing that engineers do is they fit this scave valve. It's technically known as a low pressure isolator. And sometimes, if we're lucky, they'll chuck it here and they'll say, oh, turn it 1.5 turns and it's job done. The other group of heroes, they say, I've taken the cap off the bathroom radiator and changed it to another cap. It's an automatic bypass. We've got no chance. We've got no chance with those idiots walking on the planet. No wonder we're in a mess. A radiator in the bathroom or the hall is not an automatic bypass. It's not a bypass at all. It's just a radiator that's on full non-stop with no control. And British standards require that every radiator has a TRV and make it smart. Or we've seen the Danfoss video that I've done on the return one, which is a balancing TRV, which is brilliant. That's what we should be doing. But don't stick a gate valve in there and turn it. And they also put these on a cylinder to restrict the flow to the cylinder, so it takes longer and longer to replenish the hot water, which means that the heating cools down and your gas bill or oil bill goes up, because the longer that boiler's on, the more it's going to cost you. We want the recovery to be as fast as possible and as efficiently as possible. So I don't know where this comes from. This is just a bodge, that's all it is. It's just a bodge. Automatic bypass on every system, please. That'll be brilliant. Let's have a look at the valve on top. So here we've got a Honeywell diverter valve or anybody else's diverter valve or even a zone valve. What's different about Honeywell is, of course, the motor, because this is a high quality premium valve and it's got blue wires. For some reason, installers seem to buy motors for other manufacturers and they stick them in a Honeywell, which is unbelievable. What, even worse, they film themselves doing it wrong. They spend half an hour on this workbench, fiddling around with this, put it in and say, aren't I good? So please don't repair these valves. All of them, doesn't matter who makes it, around the year of 6, they will start wearing out. And if it's been at high pressure, which is 1.5 bar to a combi in a 3-bedroom semi or lower, this gland in the middle will leak. And here's a close up, and there's the back of one. Why people change that to fix this is beyond me. I haven't worked that one out yet. I don't see that connection at all. What you're supposed to do is to drain the system down, flush it out, replace the whole valve with the latest version, and then refill. Where the wires going into the wiring center go in, cut it somewhere here lower and put a connector block. And this is an example that I've done. So that would be here. The valve would then be refitted with the latest version. And above all, don't disturb any wires here. And that's another problem that we have. Installers twist the wires together and try and bung them into the holes. Some systems have 6 neutrals, and they try and put 6 neutrals here in N. And what we teach here on a Thursday is get a great big fat blue wire and put it into terminal 9. So you can put 3 or 4 in here individually, and then 3 or 4 at 9 individually, and you get a better connection and everything works. It's not difficult, it's just having some sort of organized method. Let's move over to the room thermostat. Another troublemaker. I don't know why, but the manufacturer says, put it in the lounge. They have a picture in the lounge, on the box, as you've seen in other videos of mine about that. It says room thermostat on the box. The picture says room thermostat in the lounge. And the installer said, nah, we're not doing that. Let's put it in the hall, nice and cold, and their bills will go up. Who cares? But that's the standard we have in this country. And I don't know why. We get this all the time. So please send me more hate mails and explain to me how you put a thermostat in the hall and the customer's going to save money. I can't see that. But they do. Because remember, this thermostat is overheat. So when it gets to 20, it's supposed to switch the system off because you're just lovely and warm. If you put it in the fridge, that's going to be on and on and on, and your gas bill, oil bill, whatever fuel you're using, is going to go up and up and up. I don't see how that is an advantage at all. Why can't they just follow the instructions that's in the box and put it in the front room? And often these smart controls will insist on it going in the front of the room as part of the guarantee, which is what these are as well. With the cylinder stat, we don't seem to have much problems. But if you've got one, just check that the dial is facing towards 60. No higher, no lower. 60 is right to kill the bugs that will naturally occur in warm water. So just check that, it should be fine and it's not been obstructed by anything else. When it comes down to the programmers, again, we can upgrade them quite easily into smart and combine, instead of having a clock and a stat, we can have a programmable one. We can have it wireless. So there's endless possibilities. Ask your installer, first of all, number one, have they been on an approved course? And number two, what options do I have? And as I've said in other videos, use the boiler manufacturer's controls. That's the cheapest of the cheap. After that is open therm from these big providers, which is Honeywell, Danfoss and Drayton. They're the three tops. You can trust anything they make is going to be brilliant. So try and get the best, the smartest that they make. That's going to save you money because you're going to be stuck with this boiler for at least 12 years. And if you look after it and check it over every single year, then it will last without breaking down. Parts will wear out because they're moving, they're working. That's fine, but let's pre-plan. Every single year, the boiler gets checked over by a gas safe engineer or somebody who works for that company. Make sure it's working well. You've got plenty of inhibitor. You've got a magnetic filter and an anti-scale filter fitted to your system. No matter what you've got, if you've got a boiler, you need those basic things. That's the way you're going to have trouble-free life and low bills. If you skimp on any of them, your boiler will complain and your fuel bills will go up unnecessarily. Why? So I hope I've covered a few bits and pieces in here. Contact the manufacturers, have a look at some of the YouTube channels from the factories about how the boiler's installed, and where it's installed will make a huge difference to your bills. Have a look at my videos as well, and please subscribe and get in touch if you want another video on another topic. I've got some in the pipeline. One I've got about saving water, but I've got a couple before that one, so that's a really good one. Thanks for watching the video, and if you'd like to comment, there's a section below, and subscribe to our channels for regular updates on our next projects. Take care.